Hello friends, welcome to Study Bay Technologies, and in our today's session we are going to discuss about time convention for spherical lenses. Okay, so now let's see what are these spherical lenses. First of all, see, we have two different types of lenses. First one is something like this, and this is known as a convex lens. This is convex lens. And the other one is like this. This is concave lens. Okay, so now let's discuss how this sign conventions can take place over here. So let's say this is the principal axis, okay, and now I have a concave lens over here, fine. Now this central point, this one, you can represent it by C, right? This is something known as optical center. Right? This is optical center. Now, this line is your principal axis, and let's say I put some straight object over here, like this. Now, if an object is placed over here, it is very clear that the light is traveling from this direction towards the lens. All right. So, all the distances measured in the direction of light are considered to be the positive, right? And all the directions which are measured in the direction opposite to the direction of light are considered to be negative. Now, before going towards this point, let me make it very clear that all the distances should be measured from this optical center only, right? So, if we can correlate it with a number line, this optical center is nothing but just the origin, that is 0, 0. Okay? Now, let's say that the image is formed somewhere here, and the direction is we have to travel to this direction. In that case, we will consider this direction as positive. Why? Because we are moving in the direction of light only. Alright? On the same ground, like if image is being formed here, or some object is placed over here, so in that case, this direction is considered to be negative. Why? Because we are moving in a direction opposite to the direction of light. Okay? In the same fashion, like if we move in upward direction, look at the object here. This is actually moving, pointed upward to the principal axis, right? So if we move towards a direction, an upward direction actually, that is represented by the sign positive. Okay? Similarly, like if we move in downward direction, we represent it by negative direction. Fine. So this is how the sign convention takes place. Always remember, this movement or the measurement is to be done from optical center only. Okay, so now in the same way, we have focal length also. This focal length in case of convex and concave mirror, right? So always remember that the focal length of this convex lens is always considered to be positive. All right. And the focal length of concave mirror is always considered to be negative. For convex mirror, it is positive. For concave mirror, it is negative. And based on that, we can have lens formula. So lens formula this is given by like 1 upon V minus 1 upon U equals to 1 upon F. All right. 1 upon V minus 1 upon U, that's equals to 1 upon F. Now here, this V is actually the distance of image, or you can say this is a image distance. Right? Distance we will be measuring from this optical center only. Okay? U, this will be the distance of object, or the distance between optical center and the object. Right? Now we have this F, that is your focal length. Focal length. Now if we are using convex mirror, this focal length should be positive, and if we are using concave mirror, the focal length should be negative. Right? So with the same concept, we can find out the magnification also. But moving towards the magnification, keep this point in mind that there is also a mirror formula which is quite similar to this one, but difference in the sign convention. In case of mirror formula that you might have studied in your previous chapter, in case of mirror, the formula will be 1 upon V plus 1 upon U equals to 1 upon F. So don't get confused with this mirror or lens. In case of lens, we have a negative value sign over here, and in case of mirror, we have a positive sign over here. So don't get confused between these mirror and lens formulas. All right. Now, next point is about magnification. So magnification is represented by M. Right, and this is given by h2 upon h1. So this is the formula for the magnification. Here this h2, this represents height of image. This is height of image, and h1 represents height of object. All right. So I hope the concept is clear to you. And this magnification, you can also use the formula for the magnification as M equals to V upon U. And I'm sure you still remember what is this V upon U. V is distance of image and U is distance of object. So these are just a few formulas that you have to keep in mind for solving all kind of numericals related to the spherical lenses. Have a nice time and take care of yourself. Bye-bye.